जैसे पहले
soon for us. Just to let you know about this welcome.
Master Asmeel Sabre Ute.
It's in Suva, Fiji. I'm honored to present.
Mission
is catered for utmost.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The president of TIS Sangam, the various officials of TIS, the Nasinu branch, the head teacher, parents, and of course the students. Firstly, my apologies for the delay. I got held up in another meeting. I do not intend to make a long speech, but essentially to firstly thank TIS Sangam for these wonderful initiatives, and indeed this particular initiative regarding the building of the new building, which will cater for 16 classrooms and a new hall. Ladies and gentlemen, throughout Fiji, if you look at most of the schools essentially have been started by various faith-based organizations, by various community-based organizations. And if it weren't for these organizations, the government would have struggled right from independence time to actually cater for education for all our students. If it wasn't for these community-based organizations, if it wasn't for these faith-based organizations, there'd be a huge shortage of schools and indeed classrooms throughout Fiji. So I'd like to once again actually publicly acknowledge the wonderful contribution that TIS Sangam has made to the education sector in Fiji. As you know that in this year's budget, which has just come into effect from yesterday, the 1st of August, we have allocated over $1 billion to the education sector. And the reason why we have done so is because education is really the key to success to any country. If all of these children here receive good education, they get the opportunity to come to school without actually having to pay school fees, which government will pay on behalf of the parents. They're able to access high school, access university education. The moment they get that qualification, nobody can take that qualification away from them. It's theirs. And that becomes an asset of theirs to be able to get employment, to be able to better their lives, to be able to better the lives of the extended family. But more so economically, it makes a lot of sense. If we have a lot more Fijian people who are educated, who are well qualified, then obviously it'll ensure the economy actually grows and does well. I'd of course like to very quickly also take this opportunity to thank all the teachers. As the president highlighted, that this school obviously has a very high ratio of students to teachers, and many of the teachers we have in Fiji of course have ventured into this career because they have a passion for teaching. And indeed many of them sometimes teach under very strenuous circumstances. We of course have been trying to improve that by increasing salaries, recognizing for example head teachers of schools such as large as this to be able to reward them. But we've also announced in the budget now to be able to give scholarships to teachers, in-house teachers, for those who may have diplomas to actually upgrade themselves to degrees, those who have degrees to upgrade themselves to masters, and indeed we have some PhD positions available for civil servants to take up if should they wish to do so. So I'd like to thank the teachers for their hard work, in particular the teachers in the school for teaching so many students with such small numbers of theirs. I also want to finally thank all the parents who are here, because parents obviously are pivotal to the education system. The teachers can obviously do so much, but once they leave the school and they go home, if the home environment is not conducive to a learning environment, if the parents don't encourage their children to learn, to be able to do their homework, then obviously a lot of the work done by the teachers will not necessarily reach fruition. And that is very important. So education sector is about all stakeholders actually doing their part and fulfilling their roles for us to be able to ensure that these children here will be able to get a much better life, much better living conditions, and of course we have a much better country too in that instance. So thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. As you know, that the students don't want to listen to you because they're still talking. There's no point in me talking for too long. But I also want to take this opportunity to also remind all of you who live in the Nasinu area that this evening at Rishikul High School, we're having a budget information session. So if you're interested, around about 7:30 p.m., you can come down there and we're actually telling you about what's in the budget, how you can personally benefit from it, with a number of initiatives that we have announced, in particular, for example, the grant to families who earn less than $30,000, should they have babies, you know, how they can access the $1,000, the new maternity leave, paternity leave, and various other initiatives that we have announced. So please feel free to come there tonight and listen to the information. Once again, thank you to the school, thank you for TIS. Let's put our hands together for all the stakeholders. Come on, children, let's put our hands together for everybody. I wish you all a very good afternoon. Jazakallah. Thank you.
Thank you.